الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Dear respected brothers, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our salah. Amin ya arham rahimin. في كتاب الزهد الإمام أحمد بن حنبل mentioned that hadith. Let us learn today inshallah. He's talking, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the hadith about the best and the worst of mankind. If you try to know who's the best and who's the worst, see the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. First of all, he said, إذا أردت أن تكون الأقوى توكل على الله. If you wish to be the strongest in your community, just trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. More you put your trust, subhanallah, we read that in the Quran, in too many ayat. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he was in the cave of Thawr, when he was migrating, look how he was telling Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, what do you think about two Allah, the third of them? Trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is no harm. With trust, there is no harm at all. Look to Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam. When he was with Bani Israel, about to move from Egypt, and Pharaoh with 70,000 soldiers behind him, and the ocean, the red ocean in front of them. What happened? Said, Kalla, nay, inna ma'ya Rabbi sayhdeen. Indeed, Allah with me and he will guide me. This is what we call this trust. Don't examine Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ya Rabbi, if you make this, I will make this. If I make this, you're gonna make this. This doesn't work like this. Trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Put your trust in Allah in everything. He said, لو أنكم تتوكلون على الله حق توكله رزقكم كما يرزق الطير. تأخذوا خماسا وتروحوا بطان. If you trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, والله, he will give you provision, rizq, like the birds. He's going in the morning, empty stomach, coming full stomach. Did you see any bird, engineer or doctor or business bird? Just أفئدة الطير. Just they go flying, they don't know where they're going to get. But just trust, they trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We learn this. And they said, if you want to be the most honorable person in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in Allah's sight, what fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, إِنَّ أَكْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَغْنَاكُمْ وَلَا أَطْوَالَكُمْ وَلَا أَتْخَمْكُمْ. The most honorable amongst you in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not the richest, not the strongest, no. The one who have the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. More you have the taqwa Allah, the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fear of Allah means to follow Allah's command. Aywa, to do the duties, which is whatever is due, you have to do it. You know, and abstain from haram, be astray from it. This is the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you want to be the richest in the community, have content. Content for what? Be content. With what? With what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whatever Allah gave it to you, just be content. Does not mean just to stuck and to stay like this. No. Do your job, make it good, but the content or contentment must be in your heart. Even if you have the mal, wealth, like Qarun, you have money, you're gonna be the richest. But either you have or not, you have to have the content. Contentment. Yes. I don't have money, I have the contentment. Qana'at. Qana'ah. They call it qana'ah. I am the richest, I have contentment also. You know? Subhanallah. This is wala sawfa yu'tika rabbuka fi. فتسعد فترضى. Allah will give you, O Muhammad, until you will be satisfied. That's it. Subhanallah. This is very important. If you want to be the richest, you have to have content. Whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, shall I inform you about the worst of you? What? The worst? Yes, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that. He's saying sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. من أكل طعامه لوحده. The one who's eating his food alone, out of his what? Of his pride. I don't want anybody to stay with me, to sit with me in the table, because I am. Do you know who? You don't know who am I? Who am I? Who are you to come and sit with me in the table? And Rasulullah said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the worst table, that table which is all the rich people, they are sitting around it without the faqir, the poor person. شَرُّ مَأْدُبَةً, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that. That's why that one is eating alone out of his pride. Nobody like me, I'm the best. No. Who are you to sit with me in the same table? That person the worst. And out of his what? Second reason, stinginess, bakhil. When he put the food, close the door. Lock. If somebody knock the door, no, I'm not here. Why? He doesn't wanna spend. Bakhil, stinginess, subhanallah. For these two people, they are the worst, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. I don't want anybody to eat my food because of my pride or because of my stinginess. That person, the worst. Is he the worst? Nobody, يعني worse than him? No, still, صلى الله عليه وسلم is telling you. The second part of the hadith, صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said also, the one who beats his slave of no good reason. Actually, you don't have to beat your slave. There is no slavery now. Do you think there is no slavery now?
There is.
I have slavery now worse than the slavery before Islam. It comes back. Especially the women. Women, slavery nowadays. They put them in patrinas, naked. They sell them with money. Yes, somewhere around the world. But if you, I can see now. Before, yes, they have the slaves and they used to beat them up. And they, do you know what is the ransom of the slave? If you have a slave and you beat him up, you slap his face. You know what's in your ransom, kafara? Do you know what? To free him. Otherwise, you're going to be punished. You slap his face, he's your slave. There is no slavery now. Not like before, but I can say also, if you hire somebody for certain wage and you did not give him his money, I can consider this like that. You're hiring somebody, you treat him bad. You have a maid in your house. You treat her like a piece of trash. Why? She's a human like you. But Allah put her in that position to serve you. Say thank you. And we see this here too, but most of those who have the slaves or the maids, those who are in the Gulf area, even they bring them to America to serve them here. For these people, some of them, they are so bad. They are beating them up. They are taking their money. They are not giving them their rights. Maybe not here in America because they can sue them.
There is. There is in America. Yeah, they call it human trafficking.
Also?
Yes,
subhanAllah. See? For Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, this person, the worst person. She's a human. He's a human like you. Why you treat him like this? You know? SubhanAllah. Because Allah gave you money, you treat people like you think you're from gold and they are from Tanakh. What is this? Don't look to the people down. You are human. One day you're going to die. Whatever money you have, position you have, one day you're going to die, you're going to be in the grave like anybody else. All of us are going to stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The only one who's going to come with us, Allah. And you're going to be superior because of your good deeds, not because of your money. Your money there is nothing. Should I inform you about the one who is worse than that? Of somebody worse than that, Ya Rasulullah? The one worse than the one who's beating his slave? Worse than the one who's eating alone his food because of his pride and his stinginess? Yes, still. Man aada an-nas wa'adahu an-nas. The one, his enemy to the people and people, they are enemy to him. Nobody likes him. That person is so bad. Somebody worse than that? Yes. The one, he is not forgiving others and he's not accepting excuses. That person, astaghfirullah al-azim. We see these people in our community. Yes, khalas, if he take like certain position, you're gonna be my enemy till the day of judgment. Why? What's between me and you? Any inheritance, any land, any money, anything? Did they marry your sister, you marry my sister, or what? What's wrong with you? What's wrong with you? I see you in the masjid or in the street, assalamu alaikum, alaikum assalam. There is no business even between us. Why you have this animosity to the people? I'm not talking about anything personal, I'm talking in general. You have to forgive to be forgiven. Always they said, forgive and forget. Yes, live in peace. How to get your inner peace? While you're not forgiving others. Imagine that you have that animosity fire in your heart against people. How can you sleep? How can you eat? How can you enjoy your life? These people, they are shaitan. To be honest with you, they are big shaitans. And if somebody is not accepting the excuse, tell him, brother, I'm very sorry. No, why you did this? I'm very sorry. خلاص. I said, no, خلاص. Go to hell. What can I do? Should I kill myself for you? No. For sometimes people, when you're stuck with this, just Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَأَعْرَضْ عَنِ الْجَاهِلِينَ. When you see somebody jahil, just give him your back. Don't waste your time. Your life is very short. You don't have time to waste it for somebody jahil to make some kind of arguments or talk. No, just ignore. Step in his neck and move, go, do your mission. That's it. You don't have time for this trash stuff, you know? This filth, trash. For go.
And
what about if he did not accept the salam? اعرض. Just give your bag by. That's it. Allah said سلام عليكم لأن ابتغى الجاهلين. You don't have to make arguments with anybody. Shall I inform you, صلى الله عليه وسلم, still giving the worst? What, still somebody worse than that? Yes. Shall I inform you about the one worse than that all? The one whose evil ways people are afraid of. الذي يتقيه الناس من شره. أيوة. Yes. الذي يخافه الناس ويخاف شره. Somebody فظ غليظ, harsh. People, when they see his face from far away, no. Let me look under the street. I don't want to even see his face. That person, people, they don't want to even see his face because of his evil, his shar. Somehow, like, subhanAllah, like fire. Somehow, gonna burn your clothes. That's subhanAllah. That person, he's the worst. Like what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that one, nobody expects anything good from him. There is no khair in this person. Don't expect any good, any fruits in this person. What you have to do, how to deal with these people? Just peacefully ignore. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَإِذَا خَاطَبَهُمُ الْجَاهِلُونَ قَالُوا سَلَامُ. If the jahil talk to you, say salamu alaykum. Another verse said, سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ لَا نَبْتَغِي الْجَاهِلِينَ. Peace. I don't want to deal with jahileen. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informed Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, peace be upon him, I send you for a certain mission. Because of that very important mission to deliver the message of Islam, you're going to see a lot of trash in your way. This trash and filth, you don't have to be bothered with this. What you have to do? He said, فَأَعْرِضْ عَنْهُمْ فَإِنَّهُمْ لَنْ يَضُرُّكَ شَيْئًا. Just give your back, ignore them, they will never harm you. Yes, and he said, for the Muslims, لَنْ يَضُرُّكُمْ إِلَّا أَذَى. Just they can harm you a little, but they cannot kill you. They cannot finish your life. Because in the end, your life in the hand of Allah. Your risk in the hand of Allah. See? Very important, jama'ah. These are the best amongst you. To be the best when you trust Allah. To be the best when you have contentment. To be the best when you have the fear of Allah. To be the worst when you will be stinginess. You have pride. You have evil. People, they are afraid of your evil also. This is the worst people in the community, which the person is not forgiving others, that person is not accepting excuses, that person, subhanAllah, you never expect any good out of him. These people, they are the worst in the community. I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, أن يتقبل يا رب. اللهم تقبل منا فإنك أنت السميع العليم. واغفر لنا فإنك أنت الغفور الرحيم. تب علينا فإنك أنت التواب الرحيم. عافنا واسترنا واجبرنا واهدنا يا رب العالمين. صلى الله على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. جزاكم الله خيرا.